We may not know how much Donald Trump did or did not pay in income taxes, but we do know for sure that he amassed an astonishing amount of personal debt in the 90s, nearly $1 billion worth. How is that even possible? Trump bet big.
When casino gaming came into Atlantic City, it was a monopoly. We hired
a landscaper. Marvin Rothman analyzed the gaming business for a prominent financial services firm.
They had basically the whole eastern market to themselves, and everyone was looking for land to build a casino.
Trump liked those odds and opened two casinos in Atlantic City in as many years, Trump Plaza and Trump's Castle, all part of a spending spree in the 1980s that included the iconic Plaza Hotel in New York, a Palm Beach estate, an airline, a yacht, and the largest tract of undeveloped land in Manhattan. But for Trump, it wasn't enough. After months of complex negotiations, he bought one of the biggest casinos in the world, the Taj Mahal in Atlantic City.
And my telephone rang. And he said, "Marvin, didn't I do a terrific deal?" And I said, "I think you did a great deal, but I think you made a mistake."
Okay. You said to Donald Trump, made a mistake.
I said, "I think you made a mistake." And he said, "What do you mean?" And I said, "Why own three casinos in Atlantic City? How are you going to differentiate the marketing?" And here was his comment: "Marvin, you have no vision. This is going to be a monster property."
That needed monster financing.
How big a risk did you think he was taking?
Enormous risk. To be able to make this project successful, to break even, you'd have to generate a casino win of somewhere over $1 million a day. And no casino in the world had ever even come close to anything like that.
The Taj was the biggest bet of his career, but soon his luck would run out.
He knew he was in big trouble. I think he borrowed more than most other prudent real estate people. He had extended himself to the Trump shuttle, to a yacht, to a helicopter, and to a lot of things which weren't generating any cash flow, and he had to support his lifestyle. So he was in trouble.
Does anybody else want to bid? $190,000, we're going to sell it?
When the economy and the real estate market plummeted in 1990, attorney Alan Pomerantz says Trump owed $4 billion to his debtors, including that $1 billion for which he was personally responsible.
Because he personally guaranteed so much debt, the leverage shifted dramatically over to the banks, because it was no longer an issue of a bank and a piece of real estate, it was a bank and Donald Trump's actual survival.
Trump owed money all over town to 72 banks in all. Pomerantz represented them as a group.
How close was he to going personally bankrupt?
Very.
Trump makes a point of saying he never went personally bankrupt, but there's a reason why the banks decided to keep Trump whole.
We made the decision that he would be worth more alive to us than dead, dead meaning in bankruptcy. We don't want him to be in bankruptcy. We want him out in the world selling these assets for us.
So you wanted him alive because he was a salesman and could best sell his own properties.
That's correct. We kept him alive to help us.
"Marvin, you have no vision. This is going to be a monster property."
That needed monster financing.
How big a risk did you think he was taking?
Enormous risk. To be able to make this project successful, to break even, you'd have to generate a casino win of somewhere over $1 million a day. And no casino in the world had ever even come close to anything like that.
The Taj was the biggest bet of his career, but soon his luck would run out.
He knew he was in big trouble. I think he borrowed more than most other prudent real estate people. He had extended himself to the Trump shuttle, to a yacht, to a helicopter, and to a lot of things which weren't generating any cash flow, and he had to support his lifestyle. So he was in trouble.
Does anybody else want to bid? $190,000, we're going to sell it? That-
when the economy and the real estate market plummeted in 1990, attorney Alan Pomerantz says Trump owed $4 billion to his debtors, including that $1 billion for which he was personally responsible.
Because he
land to build a casino.
Trump liked those odds and opened two casinos in Atlantic City in as many years, Trump Plaza and Trump's Castle, all part of a spending spree in the 1980s that included the iconic Plaza Hotel in New York, a Palm Beach estate, an airline, a yacht, and the largest tract of undeveloped land in Manhattan. But for Trump, it wasn't enough. After months of complex negotiations, he bought one of the biggest casinos in the world, the Taj Mahal in Atlantic City.
And my telephone rang. And he said, Marvin, didn't I do a terrific deal? And I said, I think you did a great deal, but I think you made a mistake.
Okay. You said to Donald Trump, you made a mistake.
I said, I think you made a mistake. And he said, what do you mean? And I said, why own three casinos in Atlantic City? How are you going to differentiate the marketing? And here was his comment.
We may not know how much Donald Trump did or did not pay in income taxes, but we do know for sure that he amassed an astonishing amount of personal debt in the 90s, nearly $1 billion worth. How is that even possible? Trump bet big.
When casino gaming came into Atlantic City, it was a monopoly. We hired a landscaper.
Marvin Roffman analyzed the gaming business for a prominent financial services firm.
They had basically the whole Eastern market to themselves. And everyone was looking for